And joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Doctor, thanks for being with us.
Hey, good morning.
All right, everyone's talking about the Pfizer vaccine. I think the big thing now is this cold storage going to be distributed? How is it going so far? How do you think it's going to go?
Well, these pharmaceutical companies are quite clever. They have the resources to do this. This has no surprise. From the beginning, they knew that the storage issue was what they had to deal with, and they're dealing with it. You mentioned, the vaccines are coming out this week to 636 different sites in the United States. It's all planned out in ahead. Now, what happens when it gets there, that's another story. Hopefully, the people at the end site are ready for this, because it's not easy. There's multiple doses in a vial. They have to thaw them out, split the doses, and use it within 5 days.
So we all know that frontline workers are going to get it, seniors, people with, you know, immune issues. And I think the general public is wondering, what do I have to do to get it? How am I going to know when they're ready for me? Do they have to register at the health department of their county? Do they have to get something from their doctor? How does it work?
Well, it depends how they order the groups that are going to get it. There's debate right now. It's not decided, and it may be up to the states. Who knows? Everything else is left up to the states in this disease. But whether or not it's high-risk people or essential workers, ultimately, they're all going to get it. But what is the order that they're going to get it? People are jockeying now to this group versus that group are going to get it. There's only so many doses that are coming out per month. I mean, there's 20 million doses this month, 30 million doses, 20 million in February, 30 million in February, and 50 million in March. You know, it's going to take a while to get this out there. Logistically, say 75% of people do want to take the vaccine. That's 250 million people or so. You know, that's a lot. And just doing that is going to take a whole year.
So we're kind of in, you know, stay at home mode until then, till we get, you know, we see on the news, oh, it's time for the everyday gel.
That's true. But we're also, you know, we have the luxury of looking at the numbers. You know, if this changes behavior or the impact of the vaccine is more pronounced than we're predicting, yeah, maybe it could be a little bit more normal earlier on. Also, as other companies come forward with vaccines, Johnson & Johnson, for example, you know, that could throw another couple hundred million doses into the equation. Mm-hmm. And some of those vaccines are easier to distribute.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. With the new vaccine coming out soon, I have a lot of allergies. Do you think a steroid or Benadryl before the vaccine would help me not have a reaction?
No, nobody really knows if that's the case or not. If you have not had a severe allergic reaction, you're fair game for this vaccine. So you can go ahead and take it at the advice and recommendation of your own personal physician, because let them judge whether or not this is a severe enough allergic reaction to make you wait a little bit longer. The other thing is, remember those healthcare workers in Britain that had the reaction? I mean, they were in a hospital when they got it, and they got treated right away. Nobody has died from this reaction, but we don't want it out in a remote area where they don't have the facilities to handle a reaction. But the allergic reaction you're describing is not the allergic reaction that caused the reaction to this vaccine.
All right, next question. Are the vaccines interchangeable? If I start to vaccinate with the Pfizer one, but it's not available when it's time for the second dose, will I be able to complete the series with Moderna or another one?
No, they're different vaccines, so you have to be very careful. You want to boost the immune response to the vaccine you got the first time. Otherwise, you're basically starting over again. So it's not interchangeable.
Okay, and also we forgot to ask you at the top, there's been some speculation that the vaccine might cause infertility. Is there any truth to that?
Well, yeah, I have gotten several questions over the weekend about this, just personally, people calling me and sending me emails about this question. This is due to a blog called Health and Money News Blog, run by a Dr. Michael Yaden, from the United Kingdom. He's a very controversial figure. There is no facts to back this up. There is no basis for the statement that he has made. And also, in all the trials, people have gotten pregnant during the studies. after they had the first dose. So we're starting to gather that evidence, but there is no scientific evidence today that that is true.
Okay, Dr. Murphy, thanks for joining us. If you want to ask the doctor a question, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr.